simple as that.
He says, if you've seen me, you've seen God.
Okay. Is this something need to explanation or not?
Doesn't need explanation.
It doesn't need explanation.
You've seen me, you've seen God.
So is Jesus co-equal to God, to the Father?
To the Father? What do you mean? Like co-equal in works?
Or? Are they co-equal?
They're co-equal in terms of they are both God and they're co-equal and co-eternal, yes.
So are they co-equal?
Yes.
So they are co-equal. So Jesus and the Father are co-equal?
Yeah.
Okay. So how is Jesus, if you say Jesus is co-equal to God, is the Father all-knowing? Yeah? Is Jesus all-knowing?
Yes.
Yeah? But Jesus
before,
said...
Before you ask me, why doesn't he know the hour? Can you say yourself, if you've seen me, you've seen God?
Can I say myself, if you see me, you've seen God?
Yeah.
Depends what I mean by it. Depends if you say, if you've seen the truth,
that's
then you...
The,
maybe the truth. What's the context? Can you read the context?
You've seen me, you've seen
read
God.
The context.
He says...
Read the context.
The
all the context.
Says, how are we to know God?
All the context. Read
that
the, context.
The context.
No, read the context.
That is the context.
What's the context?
The apostles say. What's it?
Yeah, read the context. Why we go?
How can we see God?
Yeah. Okay. Read the context.
How can we see God? And then Jesus says, if you've seen me, you've seen God.
Okay. Read the context. The beginning of it.
I just did. I read to you the context.
No. That's not the context with the Bible. I wanted
the context
from the Bible. No, you read it.
I just read it to you.
No, you read what you remember. I want you to open the Bible and read the context from before, please.
What is the context?
I'm asking you.
I am reading you the context.
No, you didn't read. You mentioned the context.
That's
you didn't read
it.
I'm asking you to read from your Bible the context of that.
That is literally the context.
Okay. How did he say the Father is greater than I?
In what?
So, one second. If you see Jesus, you said you see the Father, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah? If you see,
if you see Jesus, you see God.
No, you see the Father.
God.
Okay, read the context.
It says God.
You don't want to read the context.
That is the context.
Read
the context.
Open it.
Can you say that statement yourself or not?
Now, before I say this statement, what I mean by it, if I mean by it the person himself, does he indicate, is Jesus all-knowing? So is God is all-knowing? Yes. Is Jesus all-knowing? No. So how dare Jesus will say something which contradicts himself later on? Is Jesus all-powerful? No. Jesus is not all-powerful. He was asking the help of God. So if he is all-powerful, that means he doesn't need the help of God. You understand?
I understand, but we're not going to get further in this conversation.
Yeah, because
you don't want to get further.
You see here, that's the problem.
If you don't say it.
That is the problem with you guys.
If you say it, I'll continue to speak to you.
I say what?
If you've seen me, you've seen God.
Again, what do I mean by this? It depends what it means.
Yeah, again, if you say it means.
No. If you don't want, you can move on. I don't mind. My point is, you still look at yourself now here. If I say to you under that context, is God all knowing? You said yes. Is Jesus all knowing? No. So how come you say if you see Jesus, you see Father?
I will answer that question.
How?
Soon.
How? No, listen. No one can say this, and I will tell you something. No one can say this. And even if we agreed that these are the words of Jesus, it has a context. And the context that he was using, he wasn't using the way that you understand it. The way in terms of following, the way in terms of following the religion, the way of following, that's what it means. That's the context. But now, the question is Jesus Almighty?
It's just Almighty.
I'm not going to say it because...
You're not going to say it.
Because
you would claim to be God.
No. Go back and read.
You don't want
to read the context.
I will read it.
Read it.
Read
open
it.
And read the context.
You read it.
No. Listen, you are claiming something about Jesus, correct?
Jesus is the Father.
Which he has said this, yeah?
Well, you've
read
asked
it.
Me.
Okay, read it then.
And then...
Read the context.
Okay, so if he meant, if you've seen me, aka the truth... You've seen God.
The truth.
Yeah.
Yes.
So if he's saying it that way.
Yes.
Can you also say?
If you wanted to say the truth, if you want to see the truth, yes, maybe. No problem.
No, hold on.
If you want to say, no problem. The truth. That's the understanding of it.
Say if you've seen me.
It's Jesus Almighty.
Say it.
It's Jesus Almighty.
I will answer as soon as you say
no,
it.
No, let's say it. It's Jesus Almighty.
Say it. Why not?
It's Jesus Almighty.
Why not?
It's Jesus Almighty. Is Jesus Almighty? Is Jesus Almighty? Okay, so here are my friends. Look at this. I asked him this question, a very simple question. I asked him, is Jesus Almighty? He said no.
This
is not Almighty.
I didn't say no.
Okay, I
asked.
I will ask you.
That's a lie.
Is Jesus Almighty? Simple. Is Jesus Almighty?
As soon as you answer my question.
No, before. I'm more than who was
I
asking.
I asked first.
No. I was not. You asked.
Where's your manners?
You know, here, the manners, when someone addressed you a question, you answer the question, not addressing another question
and
to him.
He doesn't answer it.
Okay. My question is to you. Is Jesus Almighty?
You don't answer my question.
So Jesus is not Almighty?
I didn't say
this
that.
This is the default. I'm saying
say
this.
That.
Okay. So here, he is admitting.
I'm not admitting
according
anything.
To what he says. According to what he says, I'm claiming Jesus is not Almighty. Yeah? I'm claiming this. Can you dismantle this?
Can you say it?
Can you dismantle this?
Can you say it?
Okay, you don't want to say it. Okay. So here, our friend here is saying, Jesus is not Almighty according to his approval. Why? Jesus, he said, in very straightforward claimant, in front of everyone, saying to them, the Father is greater than I. If the Father is greater than I, if the Father is greater than I, did Jesus say the Father is greater than I? Did Jesus say the Father is greater than I?
Answer my question.
Did Jesus say the Father is greater than I? You see here. So that's my point. So Jesus said the Father is greater than I. So if you say here, what do you want to, they want you to say? Jesus is claiming the Father is greater than him. And he said, if you see me, you see the Father. How come? What is contradiction? How this contradiction in the Bible? The Father is greater than him. The Father is all-knowing. The Father is all-powerful. And yet, they will say with their audacity, they will have audacity to say, okay, Jesus said, if you see me, you see the Father. How come? What kind of nonsense is this? So that's why, my friend, you need to learn firstly your Bible first. That's first of all. That's something which is I advise you to do that. I asked you, I give you the chance to read the context. You didn't, which you failed to do it. You failed to do it. The whole context.
The context.
No, read it. I don't want your memory. I don't trust the memory of the Christian. Do you memorize it?
Yes.
No, read it from the whole thing.
Which chapter? John.
All of it, read it.
Read all of John?
Yeah.
I can't read all of John.
Okay then, you see here.
Mohammed didn't memorize the Quran, did he?
No, he didn't.
No, he didn't. He forgot surahs.
No, that's not true.
That is true, it's in your hadiths.
That's not true, that's a lie. That's a big fat lie, as they say.
Islam is a big fat lie.
You are a fat liar. That's true. That's why you're a fat liar in terms of talking.
No, he said his own books are lies.
Going back.
Your own books?
Which own books? Tell me. Which one? Where?
He said, thank you for reminding me. Are you going to let me?
Yeah, where? Hey, Sahih Bukhari, I'm here with me. Which one? Which chapter?
So type if...
No, not type. Where? Sahih Bukhari, where?
I can't remember the verse.
Okay, that's what, if you don't know, why do you lie? Say, where?
Type.
Where? No, not type. Where?
Type.
Where?
Are you going to let me
finish? No, I'm asking you, where? Type. In Bukhari, where?
Type.
Where in Bukhari? In Bukhari, you said in Bukhari. He said in Bukhari. Yeah? No, he's a Christian.
You're basically referring to the hadith of the Kalani ayat kada wa kada.
Yeah. My point is, did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is he a human being? We never claim that he's infallible. We never claim this. We said he's a human being. The things happen to him like any other human being. He forgets and Allah reminded him. And Allah has preserved the Quran not through him alayhi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam only, and as well through the Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When they have said, radiallahu anhum, in the last year of his death, alayhi salatu salam, that Jibreel alayhi salam came to him and recited the whole Quran to him. And then he, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he went and he recited, and then he recited back the whole Quran on Abdullah ibn Mas'ud and Ubay ibn Ka'b, radiallahu anhum ardahum. And then they took it from him. Amazingly, both of them, they have, and that this was in two different occasions. They have done it. So that's why. My point is, my friend here, with our so-called scholar who doesn't know how to quote things, we never claimed that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is infallible. We say he is a human being, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Allah said about him, confirming that wahal kuntu illa bashar rasula. I'm only a human being, but a messenger of Allah, sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So anyway, this is the conclusion of this, of our discussion here. And again, he failed to demonstrate. He failed to demonstrate that Jesus, peace be upon him, is co-equal to God, as I asked him in the first thing. And he said he's not asking, he's not even confirming this. So anyway, that's what we have. What we have to do. We finished here, and
your friend agreed with you.
I will tell you something.
I'll tell you
And this is for all our Christian friends. Your religion is dying out, and that's fact.
It's not.
Your religion is fading away.
It's not.
Which is true.
It's not.
And eventually, there will be no Christian walking on earth. That something will happen.
Well,
that's something. Yeah, of course. Which heaven now?
Not Jannah.
No.
Jannah's
you see
heaven.
Here, and that's why those people. This Allah says in the Quran about the people of the book. Allah says, confirming this, confirming about them, the envy in their heart. They don't want any guidance to come to us because of the envy of their heart. And that's why Allah. That's something which is known. I ask Allah to guide them. I ask Allah to guide them to the right path. To guide our friend here to the right path, to bring him to the truth of Islam.
Wassalamu
alaikum wa rahmatullah.